Hello students, today's topic is male reproductive system. When we talk about male reproductive system, and the first thing is what are the various parts. So the parts of male reproductive system are divided into two types, primary parts and secondary or accessory parts. Now primary parts are a pair of testes, which are enclosed in a bag or pouch-like structure called scrotum or scrotal sac. Now, why are testes the primary sex organs? This is because of the reason that in each testes there are large number of seminiferous tubules. And the main function of gonads or the sex organs is to produce gametes. So, the male gametes, the sperms, are produced in these seminiferous tubules. The spermatogenesis takes place here. So the testes are the primary sex organs. Now you can see the space between the seminiferous tubules is filled with another type of cells called Leydig cells. Now the function of testes are two. Testes performs dual function. Number one, the production of male gamete, that is sperm. Number two, the production of male hormone, that is testosterone. And testosterone hormone is responsible for secondary sexual characters in case of males. So the testosterone is produced by these cells called Leydig cells. Okay. Now we come to the accessory or the secondary organs. Now the sperms which are produced here, then the ducts open and this cap like structure which is there in the ovary, testes, this cap like structure called epididymis. So the sperms get stored here in the epididymis. From the epididymis, the sperms enter into this tube-like structure called vas deferens, and it ascends up. While ascending, it receives the secretions from seminal vesicles, prostate gland, and Cowper's gland. It also receives urine from urinary bladder, and then it continues into this tube called urethra. Now urethra is covered by muscular penis, which has very very rich supply of blood. Now the sperms mix with the secretions of seminal vesicle, prostate gland and Cowper's gland, and this mixture, that is sperms, secretion of Cowper's gland, prostate and seminal vesicles, is called semen. It is a milky white fluid. Now this semen is ejaculated and transferred to the female genital tract with the help of penis, right? So the accessory sex organs are also very very important. Now why penis is having a rich supply of blood? So that at the time of sexual intercourse, when there is increase of flow of blood in the penis, it helps in erection and it makes it easy to pass the sperm semen into the female genital tract. Now what is the function of these seminal vesicle, prostate and copper glands? Now seminal vesicles, the sperms are mobile, but the secretion of seminal vesicles increases its mobility. Now prostate gland makes the semen alkaline, and the copper gland secretion help in lubrication during the sexual act. And the secretions of these and sperms, I already told you, called semen, and these secretions also, you know, act as a nutrient medium for the sperms. So during the sexual act, the semen is transferred into the vagina or the genital tract of the female, and the sexual process completes. Now the other function of urethra is to pass out urine, that is micturition, but it can perform only one function at one time. When it is when micturition will take place, ejaculation will not take place. That is, when the person is passing urine, he can't ejaculate. And when ejaculation is taking place, and then micturition or urine can't be passed at that time. Right? Now, these tubes are responsible for carrying the sperms, and during vasectomy what happens is that these tubes are cut, ligated, tied, so the sperms can't enter into the semen. So semen is now without sperm, but there are some doubts, you know, myths in the mind of males that it leads to loss of virility or something, but there is no such effect on the person. It helps in family planning, it helps in avoiding pregnancy due to sexual intercourse. So that is all about male reproductive system. Thank you.